our Lord, the most holy one, the most perfect one, the most blessed one, thou that has been given us the power, you have been giving us your glory, you have been giving us the wisdom, you have been giving us the knowledge. You are the Lord of Lords, you are the King of Kings, everlasting Father, thou that has the soul of every soul. We shall be calling you at all times. We shall be praising you inasmuch as we are still alive, because you are so mighty in our lives. We value you, we know your power. We know everything that you do in our lives. We know your grace. We know the mercy that you endow unto this generation. We know the grace that you've given to us, O Lord, to live with us. We know the blessing that you are putting on us, O Lord, for this wonderful grace that are listening to the hour of peace, and even the soul that is speaking right now. Glory be to your name. Glory be to your name. Glory be to your name. It's only the living that will be able to praise you. The dead cannot praise you. They are waiting for the judgment. Those that are still alive, we will continue to exalt your name. We will continue to praise you. We thank you for the wondrous things that you're doing in our lives. For those that love to be listening to this Hour of Peace program, King of Glory, accept our thanks. Everything that is happening around us is not our power. It's not our wisdom. It's not our knowledge. It's your power, O Lord. It's your glory, O Lord. It's your wisdom, O Lord. Only you can do it. No one else can do it. Everlasting Father, accept our thanks. Accept our thanks. We are now going to the old world now. Everlasting Father, to speak your words. King of Glory, speak through us. And every soul that shall be listening to this word, give them peace. 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 If there's any problem and tribulations on them that does not want them to listen to this word, O Lord. If there's anything that we assert more than you, O Lord, that does not make us to listen to your words, everlasting Father, take these things away from us. Take them away from us so that we'll be able to listen to your words. So that we'll be able to listen to your words. So that we'll be able to listen to your words. The power of the word of the Lord, let you come unto us, O Lord, for us to be able to behave in your way. Today, let it be a glorious day in our lives. So shall it be. In Jesus' name, we have prayed. Amen. 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 We thank the Lord for his grace upon our lives, for the mercy that he has endowed upon us, for us to be on this program. In Jesus' name, the Lord will continue to be with us. Today, what I want to say, don't be scared about it by the time you are listening. Don't be scared at all by the time you are listening to it. Do you know, I'll tell you at all times that no matter how powerful one is, if they go to the trees, if they go to the rock, to curse you, if you have your faith in the Lord, no matter their cause, it will not have any power over you. It will not have anything to do with you. The Lord will surely conquer for you. Now, what you see that wants to happen, or what you see that has already happened, that's what this word of this morning is for. It wants to tell you about what has happened before, or what wants to happen. Listen now, this morning, do not fast forward this word to only where the prayer is. Listen from the beginning, throughout to the end. Don't say that the word is too harsh. No matter how harsh it is, try and listen to everything. Don't fast forward towards the end where there's prayer. No, don't fast forward it at all. You need to be able to listen from the beginning. Because in listening from the beginning, there is victory in it. What is the topic of my sermon this morning? I want you to listen fully well. I don't even know where we are going this morning. It is the way that I'm hearing it from the Lord that I will speak to you. The topic of this morning is Ichabod. Ichabod. Ichabod is in the book, in the Bible. It's a name of someone in the Bible. And I'm going to read it to you. Ichabod, meaning goodbye to glory. Goodbye to glory. Goodbye to glory. And I refer to this. Going back to square one. You will not go back to square one in Jesus' name. The Lord will continue to be with you. You will never go back to square one. You know, people can make someone to go back to square one. Yes, if you have a child, if people can pull back their glory. Because you now be wondering, that what's happening to this child? Is this the child that I gave back to? That means they made that child to go back to square one. They've turned things around for that particular child. They put the evil up and then put the good part of that particular child. They will turn it around. Someone's job, they can turn it around. The peace in someone's life, they can turn it around. Someone that is about 40 years old will not look like 80 years old. Can you imagine? They can make someone to go back to square one. They can put problems in one's life. They can put sickness in one's life. And by the time they put sickness in one's life, a 40-year-old will not look as if it's 80 years. So today, you better listen to this program and pray. You better listen and pray very well. Today, if there's anything that has been put in your glory, that has not made your glory to show, that do swallow glory. If there's anything that you've eaten that is swallowing your glory, if there's anything that you are putting on that is swallowing your glory, today, Holy Spirit will pull you out. Holy Spirit will conquer for you. The Lord of Hour of Peace is a powerful God. He's the one that delivers someone. Do not be stiff-necked. Do not be stiff-necked. And do not forsake the word of the Lord as your forefathers has done. Don't do that at all. It's not only the word of Hour of Peace. Any word of the Lord, try and listen. Anything that is talking to you about the problems of your life, try to listen. Since the day our forefathers has eaten the sour grape, that's the day that our teeth has started to be aching us. You need to be able to listen to these words. And you need to be able to pray. It is our faith and our belief that all those that are lacking, all those that are in need, you think they are the one that has problem. Not only them, even you that are fully blessed, you that is rich, you still have some problem that is making you to be sad. That's what we call going back to square one. Going back to square one. Yes, I'll try to my topic, Ichabod, meaning the glory has come to an end. The glory has come to an end. Going back to square one. Because if your glory is gone out of you, that means you are going back to square one. People will say, oh, what's not happened to this woman? What's not happening to this man? Look at the way she is now. If the Lord lives and you are still alive, and you are still alive, I pray for you today. Your glory will arise today. No one will be able to have the authority to do anything bad to your glory. Going back to square one is really bad. It's nothing good at all. It always pulls people back. It takes you back. And it cuts people's lives short. Because when you have this particular problem, when you are going back to square one, you will continue to always be thinking. And from thinking, you have high blood pressure. And this can lead to a very serious sickness. Then you can die. Then you can die. Someone that has been giving people, you've been blessing people, and now you are now begging to eat. Don't you see it's a terrible thing? Someone that has been blessing people with cars and now started trekking, no more car. And people are now even considering giving him lifts. But because they haven't got space in their car, they are now saying to you, oh, daddy, mommy, we are sorry. We wanted to give you lifts, but there's no space in our car. Don't you think that person will be thinking and nearly want to kill himself? That person can even commit suicide. I am saying to you, my fathers and mothers in the Lord, do not allow anybody to take you back to your village. Do not allow anything to take you back to your village. You are now in London. You are now in America. Do not allow anything to take you back to your village. You can see that anytime that I'm speaking on this forum, I always touch different areas. I always cover different areas so that you can be able to pick the one that is yours. Do not forget, I have been sent unto this generation so that everybody can be able to check themselves and come back to the Lord. Even myself, I'm making use of the words too to be able to correct my mistakes so that I can have the opportunity of sitting at the right hand of the Lord Jesus Christ. That's the reason why I'm speaking to you. Please try and make use of these ways. Be careful not to be going back to your square one. Even on your business, if you have problem on that particular business, oh, you can go back to square one. No matter how blessed you are, if that problem comes into you, you can go back to square one. I pray for you that you will not go back to square one in Jesus' name. You will not go back to square one in Jesus' name. Don't you know when you are sick and you cannot move, you cannot lift your legs, you cannot lift your hands, you just be waiting for people to carry you to bathroom to go and bath. If you want to go and use the toilet, you'll be waiting for people to carry you to toilet. I pray for you. This will not be your portion. You will not go back to square one. This is the reason this country that you are, do not allow this country to turn you to somebody proud. Do not allow it to turn you to God before people. Do not mock people. Do not mock people. You can never see me mocking people. If I want to fight with you, I will fight with you. It's going to be physical combat. Everybody will know that we are fighting. But I will never mock anyone. It's forbidden for me to mock anyone. Because in as much as I'm still alive, why do I know that can happen to me in future? I pray that good happens to us. That's the reason I always say to you, when you are in peace, do not overrejoice. Do not overrejoice, because you will not believe that there is a problem. You will think that everything is rosy and grooming. You will not want to listen to whatever we are saying. And you want to be comparing yourself that there is a lie, that there is no problem. There is a church there, there is no problem. Oh, I'm sorry for you. I'm sorry for you. I am sorry for you. Whatever that you are looking afar, you cannot judge them because you don't know their foundation. If you go to them to go and find out, they will have say to you everything that they've gone through. If you go to them, they will have told you that they are not the one who started that foundation. Those that were on that foundation from the beginning, they really suffered a lot. And you will be surprised that I thought you are the one that started it. They will say, no, I'm not the one that started it. You better be careful. You better be careful. You better be careful. Haven't you seen people that are on journey? They traveled in that car and they had an accident. About 19 of them, 18 were dead. Only one was alive. What can you say to the Lord? What can you say unto the Lord? Yes, that's why I'm calling you now. You need to pray. Listen to the word of the Lord. You that is alive, you're supposed to be wondering, what have you given unto the Lord? For the Lord to keep you safe. For the Lord to keep you alive. Oh, if that glory is gone out of you, if that glory is gone out of you, that's what we refer to as going back to square one. By the time you lose your job, by the time you have problems, oh, that's going back to square one. Because that job that you've been doing, if you lose it suddenly, it's going back to square one. It's going back to square one. I just pray for you. Keep on praying. And I pray that you not have problem. I pray that your glory will not be corrupted. I pray that you not be called Ichabod. You not be called Ichabod. Ichabod is a terrible name. If someone is being called Ichabod in spirit, if your name is being turned to Ichabod, that means you lose your glory. That means you are saying goodbye to your glory. In any family that you are being called Ichabod, oh, then that's a problem. I will read it to you. Those that are used to the Bible will have known where I'm talking about. They will know where I'm coming from. They will know what part of the Bible it is. Even you that has been reading it and you heard about that name but you don't know the meaning, you need to be able to listen to understand the meaning this morning. If that glory is gone out of someone, it's going back to square one. It's going back to square one. If you lose your job, you will become a beggar. You'll be begging to eat. You'll be begging to eat. And that's going back to square one. When this happens to you, you will know truthfully there is Lord. There is Lord. Because gradually, you'll be now begging. You'll now be asking. You'll be waiting upon people before you can eat. I pray those enemies that want you to go back lacking, I pray that Lord will conquer for you. Those enemies will not meet up with you. Those enemies will not meet up with you. You and that particular enemy, that separation between you, you are delivered. That enemy that is expected to start begging before you can eat, you are delivered from them in Jesus' name. I pray you be separated from all those enemies. I always pity people in this country. How long are we going to be like this for? It's so sad. Because even if you are fully blessed and you cannot make use of your money, if you buy a house and take a mortgage, if you don't pay your mortgage, they can repossess that property. This country, when you have your money and you have a problem with police, you cannot bribe them. So I now keep wondering, what is the importance of it? Even if you are fully blessed, you cannot enjoy your money. Only in Nigeria, you can do as you like. This country, you cannot do that. I pray for you. Going back to square one will not be your portion in Jesus' name. You will not go back to square one. Yes, that's the reason why you don't need to fight with me. And do not fight with the Lord. Because the word I am speaking is the word from the Lord. Do not say that I've been to theology school. It's not about theology. If you go to theology school and the Lord has not given you the interpretation or the meaning of whatever that you've been saying, if you don't have the full understanding, you can misinterpret the word of the Lord. Someone was speaking to me. She said, he used to send a message all around. Somebody sent me that message on WhatsApp. Oh, it's so sad. A Christian, listen to me. Don't forget about what I'm saying. I'm talking about Ichabod. Ichabod, goodbye to glory. I am talking about going back to square one. Now, I am talking about those of you who are always say that you are theologians, that you study your Bible fully well, that you are so proud. I'm talking to you now. I'm talking to you now that you need to listen. It's dangerous for you not to listen because many a times you might be thinking that you are so wise and you will not know that you're already lost before the Lord. So you have to be careful and listen. That man sent me that message. If you want it, ask me. I will send it to you because it's still on my phone. It has not been deleted. This man said what he was saying, that we Christians, we should be prepared and start killing Muslims. I know many of you are supporting this right now. He said we should go and look for cutlass and start killing people. And it's referring to Bible. He said because of the spirit of the Lord that is upon him. He first of all prayed before started talking. He said people that are killing these Muslims, that they will enter into the kingdom of God. And he was referring to Bible. He was quoting Bible references to back up whatever he was saying. Can't you see the way the interpretation of the Bible, people are interpreting it, is so sad. And I know many of you will support this man in what he was saying. It's so sad. It's so sad. Don't turn Bible around so that you will not lose your glory. Do not turn the Bible around. And I'm pleading to you. Do not misinterpret the Bible. Do not misinterpret the Bible. Yes, be careful. Even myself, when I'm listening to people's sermon in the Bible, I always pick my pen and jot it down because I want to go back and read. I want to go back and study it. That man said we should start to be killing people. We all now should become murderers because Muslims are so terrible. They are killing Christians. And I know that you people are supporting. Most of you must have been supporting this man. When the Bible said to us, do not kill, that thou shalt not kill. And this particular person is still quoting Bible. This is so sad. This is so sad. Do you now want to start killing? This person mentioned David. He mentioned Saul. Mentioned all those that kill people in the Bible. And he was even referring to the Bible. Quoting references from the Bible to back himself. This is so sad. Listen fully well today. If you kill anybody, you will be killed. If you kill anybody, you will be killed. That is it today. Because that's not what I'm being sent. What I am being sent to tell you this morning is that you should listen so that you can change. What I want you to understand today is there's a name called Ichabod. There's a name called Ichabod, meaning goodbye to glory. Goodbye to glory. The Yorubas will say going back to square one. I pray, do not allow any glory. Do not allow your glory to go to get out of you. Do not allow yourself to go back to square one. Please, I am pleading to you. I am pleading to you. I am pleading to you. Yes, this family that slept in that house on that day, they were being wiped off because of their sin. They were being wiped off because of their sin. So you have to be very, very careful not to go back to square one. You have to be very, very careful not to go back to square one. You have to be very, very careful not to lose your glory. Yes, walk in the way of the Lord. Stand in the Lord. Stand in his will. Let me ask you, the Lord that has given you that glorious glory, that you have to move from curses, come into glory. Come into the power of the Lord, from that problem to success. And will you not allow them, and will that Lord allow them to be able to corrupt your glory? No, he will not allow them. He will not allow them. He will not allow them. Be careful. Be careful. The Lord is the one that has made you to be in this position. Remember, you are not being born into this country. You are not being born to this country, but the Lord help you to be in this country. So you have to be careful. You have to be careful. Someone that was married before and now is single, is going back to square one. He's going back to square one. Be careful. Be careful. Be careful. You can see yourself. Some people can give you their experience. They can give you their experience. They can give you what they've been going through for the past 10 years. Yes. Yes. When you listen to people's experience, you will be able to see what I'm talking about. Now, you that is already walking in the way of the Lord, the latter glory will be bettered than the previous ones. Yes, but you have to be able to hold on to the Lord. You have to be able to hold on to the Lord. Hold on to the word of the Lord. Study it and make use of it. You have to meditate in it morning and night and make use of it. Yes, be careful. We are going to pray together this morning. Yes, we will pray together. Those problems that kill someone little by little, little by little, little by little, and you will not realize, and you will not realize. Little by little, that problems coming to you, and you will not realize. Little by little, they be killing you. They be killing you softly, softly, until when you finally realize. We have to pray against this kind of spirit today. You have to pray against this kind of spirit today. You must be fully prepared to pray. Yes, even if you are really, really rich, by the time you want to become poor, you will not know. It is not sudden. It will be coming gradually, 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 to the point that you now be spending your credit card. I pray for you. If there's any curse on you, that you make it to go back to square one. Maybe from your father's family. Maybe from the family of your mothers. Maybe among your friends. If there's any spirit that want to make it to go to back to square one, I pray. If there's any garments that has been tacked back to square one, that they want to put upon you, I pray today, Holy Spirit will burn them with fire. Holy Ghost fire will burn them down. Holy Ghost fire will burn them down. I pray that Lord will be with you. The Lord will be with you. Quickly, we have to go into the word of the Lord. Yes, to read it for so that you can understand. So that you can understand what you are saying. I'm not just forming anything that I say to you. They all are in the Bible. They are in the Bible. When you are on phone, you can talk and talk and talk for 2 hours. You can be backbiting for hours. 2 hours, you are still talking. But by the time that we are talking, the word of the Lord, you will not be saying that it's too long. You say that it's too long. Hear this morning. I'm going to read to you from the book of Samuel. First Samuel chapter 4. Reading from verse 18 to 22. 1 Samuel 4:18-22. I will summarize it for you now. Prophet Eli that has been chosen by God. Some people will say that Eli is not the prophet of God. Don't make a mistake. It's a prophet of God. The Lord is the one that has appointed him. He spoke and it came to pass in the land of Israel. But Eli were unable to train his children. He didn't train the children. Anytime they are talking about children, just leave them alone. Leave them alone, they will change. That's what caused him to fall. That's what caused Eli to fall. But the voice of the Lord came out unto the family and said, there's glory in your family, there's blessing in your family, and I've made you the prophets in Israel. If not for that, they wouldn't have been able to send Samuel unto him. But the Lord knows that he has glory. That's why that Samuel was being taken unto him. Who will give their son to a wicked person? And can you see, he was even saying to Samuel that go and sleep. When you hear that voice again, say, Lord, speak on. So are you not telling me that he does not know the Lord? He knows the Lord. Of course he knows the Lord. But his children made him to fall. His children made him to fall. That's one. Are you not telling me that he's not a prophet of the Lord? There are so many things to be learned in the story of Eli. Yes. I don't want to really go here and there. There are so many things to be learned. A lot of lessons in the life of Eli. Yes. Not only Eli, but use Eli as yourself. Use Eli as your household today. Compare this with yourself. Compare this with your family. Yes, your children is misbehaving and you are not checking them. When the problem comes, you will be the one to suffer for that problem. That child that you are noticing that from the beginning, from the youthful age, it doesn't want to be obedient and you didn't do anything to it. This is the same way Eli was. But when the Lord wanted to visit Eli, by all this problem, the Ark of Covenant that was being put in the house of Israel to teach them, to direct them, to show them when there is a problem. That particular Ark of Covenant, by what they are doing, by this their misbehavior, they lost that Ark of Covenant. And that day, Eli Hophinis, they died. Hophinis and Phineas, they were dead. Hophinis and Phineas, they were dead on this particular day. And that is the problem. Ark of Covenant is the word of the Lord. Ark of Covenant that we are talking about is the word of the Lord. It is the word of the Lord that we are talking about. Can you see what happened? When I'm speaking about the Ark of Covenant, many people will hate me, but I don't want to talk about it. I'm not going to that side. Ark of Covenant is the word of the Lord. Yes, it's the word of the Lord that is directing people and teaching people. And they know that as soon as this thing has left Israel, then freedom has left them. And because of this, their father was so scared and Prophet Eli died. So after his death, what now happened? After Eli's death, what now happened? I will read to you from 1 Samuel 4 from verse 18. 1 Samuel 4 from 18. And it came to pass, when he made mention of the Ark of Covenant, that he fell off from the sea backward by the side of the gate, and his neck broke, and he died, for he was an old man and heavy. He was so heavy. So as soon as he fell, there was a problem. And he had judged Israel 40 years, and his daughter-in-law, Phinehas' wife, was with child, near to be delivered. And when she heard the tidings that the Ark of God was taken, and that her father-in-law and her husband were dead, she bowed herself and travailed, for the pains came upon her. That means it was in labor. It was in labor. And about that time of her death, the women that stood by her said unto her, "Fear not, for thou hast borne a son." But she answered not, neither did she regard it, you see, because she hasn't got any power anymore. She could not speak, she could not talk. Can you see? When glory comes out of you, it is problem. It is problem. It is problem. When that glory comes out of you, it's problem. Keep your glory. Keep your glory. Keep your glory. I am speaking to you. You must be able to keep your glory. When that problems come, there's no one that cannot go through that problem. He went to Saul, and Saul started worshiping idols. He can go on to a king of a country. A rich person can become poor. Do not allow yourself to go back to square one. Do not allow anybody to take you back to square one. Be very, very careful. Be very, very careful. Anybody can go back to square one. Forbid this. Forbid it in your life. Forbid this in your life. You hear that name in this word. Yes. It says at this time, all the women that stood by her said unto her, "Fear not, for thou hast borne a son." But she answered not, neither did she regard it. Verse 21. And she named the child Ichabod, saying, "The glory is departed from Israel." Can you see? That's where the word of this money came out. That's where we are taking this topic from. Can you see? He said, "Named the child Ichabod, saying, 'The glory is departed from Israel, because the ark of God was taken.'" When the glory has already gone out of someone, that is what happened here. When the covenant of the Lord has been corrupted, and it says, "And because of the father-in-law and her husband." Can you imagine? I want you to go back on YouTube to listen to this word fully well. You can listen to it on YouTube. You can go on Open TV to listen to it later. Go there and listen for free. It doesn't cost you anything. You will listen to this word today on YouTube. Remember the one that I titled, "Can God Promise Fail?" I told you, God promise can fail. When you enter into sin, his glory can be lost. Can you see? The woman said, "The glory has departed from Israel, because the Ark of Covenant was taken." The Ark of Covenant is the word of God in your life. If you lose this, then there's a problem in your life. You have to be careful. You have to be careful. Do not form cackles. Do not join others to do evil. You know where you are coming from? Don't you know where you are coming from? You know, do not exalt anyone more than God. No. Let me ask you, all those friends, all those people that you exalt so high,
How many of them have been able to conquer for you? They don't have any help. The only help that they can have is from the Lord. Only God can help. Only God can deliver. Only God can conquer. Only God can give you everything that you want in life. You need to be able to hold on to this God. Do not allow yourself to go back to square one. Do not allow yourself to go back to square one. No. Ichabod. 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 The glory has departed from you. Not only in Israel. Remember, you are the tribes of Israel in Africa. Do not allow your glory to be lost. If there's no more peace in one's life, that person is in problem. That person is in problem. Even if you are a child of God and you've gone back to now be worshiping idols, that's going back to square one. That's going back to square one. You must be able to follow this Lord. Now let us go into a prayer. Call Apostle Christ wherever you are and say, all those garments of going back to square one that the world want to put upon me, that is being hanged for my sake, call upon the Jesus Christ today. Anywhere that we put all those garments of problems, all those garments of going back to square one, it's not for me. It's not for me. It's not for me. It's not for me. Because when you want to put that garment on, you will go and do something terrible. It's like you going to fornicate. It's like going for you to go and commit adultery. And that glory will be lost. And then you go back to square one. Many a times, you go and mingle yourself with the spirits of the darkness. And they will tell you, forget about your glory and come and join us. Call upon Jesus Christ and say, all those garments of going back to square one that has been hanged, that is supposed to have been burned by fire and has not been burned by fire. Holy Spirit, I call upon you, for I have listened to the word of the Lord today. Every sign of going back to square one, every garment of going back to square one that I am putting upon myself, that the enemies have put upon me, that is making me to be in problem for 3 years, 4 years, and more than that. Oh, heaven, begin to burn them with fire. All those garments, burn them down with fire. Continue to pray in Jesus' name, in Jesus' name, in Jesus' name. Everlasting Father, King of kings, Lord of lords, all those garments of going back to square one, King of glory, begin to burn them down, begin to burn them down, begin to burn them down, send them down, remove those garments on me, remove on me, O Lord, remove them on me, O Lord. Holy Spirit, deliver me today, deliver me today. In Jesus' name I prayed, amen. Call upon the Father, Lord Jesus Christ. All those power that has named Ichabod in spirits, King of glory, all those power that has named Ichabod in spirits that are making me to be in poverty. Oh, the glory has gone is the meaning of Ichabod. Goodbye to glory is the meaning of Ichabod. Glory has departed from them is the meaning of Ichabod. I pray today, every spirit that is bringing me back to poverty, every sign of poverty in my life, begin to break, begin to break, begin to break. Every sign of going back to square one in my life, begin to break. Holy Spirit, fire from above, begin to burn them down. Continue to pray in Jesus' name, in Jesus' name, in Jesus' name. Everlasting Father, King of kings, every sign of poverty in my life, begin to flee, begin to flee. Depart from me. Help me, O Lord. Help me, O Lord. Help me, O Lord. In Jesus' name I pray, amen. Call upon Jesus Christ. All those enemies that have marked a day for my glory, that they are saying in their sense that I have to use my glory for certain years. After those years, I should go back to poverty. Oh, do not say that this word is not for you. Be careful. Be careful. Be careful. People always phone us to give us testimony of what they are going through. By the time we listen to some, I am always scared. So don't just be like that. Continue to pray. Listen to the words and make use of it. Even those that are so powerful in prayer, they are already falling. The mighty are falling. Do not say that you know how to pray. Do not say that you are strong in faith. Don't deceive yourself. Mighty men are falling. Call upon Jesus Christ wherever you are. Call upon his name. and say, oh Lord, let me tell you, I've been anointed for the past 10 years. It's just stories. All those are histories. All those are histories. Prophet Eli was able to pray more than you. He did wonders in Israel. Everybody knows him fully well. But when that glory left his family, he died in the middle of his year. Call upon the Father Jesus Christ 3 times. All those enemies that are already telling you that you are going to use that your glory for certain years, that after that years is problem. King of glory, judge them today. Judge them today. Judge them today. Judge them today. They must not live to the end of this month unless they repent and change. Oh, all those enemies. All those enemies. King of glory. King of glory. Begin to count days for them. Begin to count days for them. Begin to count days for them. Continue to pray in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. By the power of the Lamb. Those enemies that want me to die, that are counting days for me, that they are counting days for me to die. In Jesus' name, I pray. Those enemies that wants to call me Ichabod. I am not Ichabod, O Lord. I am not Ichabod, O Lord. I am not Ichabod, O Lord. All those enemies that want me to live in glory for certain years, after that year that I should go back to poverty. Everlasting Father, swallow them up today. Help me, O Lord. In Jesus' name I pray, amen. Call upon Jesus Christ and say, every behavior of my Father's house that always puts all those stupid garments upon someone, that put the garment of poverty upon someone, you are the one that is causing it on your family. Now call upon Jesus Christ and say, all those spirits of my forefathers that I have inherited from them, all those ones that I inherited from my grandmother, all the ones that I inherited from my great-great-grandfathers, King of glory for my family house, that makes me to remove the garment of goodness and not put on the garment of sorrow. Everlasting Father, call upon Jesus Christ today, that spirit must be able to leave you today, that you be separated from that spirit. Every spirit that is contrary to the wish of the Lord in my life, all those contrary spirits that are attacking my glory, that wants to hijack my glory, call upon the Lord Jesus Christ, that all those spirits today, may they be buried. May they be buried. These spirits, King of glory, send them out. Continue to pray in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name, in Jesus' name, Everlasting Father, King of kings, Lord of lords, all those spirits, all those spirits, all those spirits, all those contrary spirits that want me to lose my glory, that I have inherited from my forefathers, Everlasting Father, chase them out with fire, chase them away with fire, chase them away with fire, so that I can have peace. Help me, O Lord, be merciful unto me. In Jesus' name, I have prayed, amen. Call upon Jesus Christ 3 times. Holy Spirit, 1 time. All those spirits that are stealing my glory, little by little. That's a powerful prayer I heard from someone. I said, oh, wow, Jesus is really using people to pray. All those prayer points, and I borrowed that prayer point, and I'm going to use it for you today. I'm going to use that prayer point for you today. Hear me fully well. Hear me fully well. People will be eating your glory little by little, little by little. All those spirits that's making you to gamble, spirit of gambling, gambling in your life. You say, oh, today I will win. Tomorrow I will win. Today I will win. Tomorrow I will win. And you'll be giving there your money. You'll be giving there your money. It will not get to a point that you don't have any money to gamble anymore. Why will you go and be gambling? Oh, that spirit that makes you to look as old as 80 years, when you are just 40, when you are only 40, but you are looking as if you are 80, that glory that makes you to look very old, when you are still very young, is problem. Call upon Jesus Christ and say, all those spirits that are eating my glory little by little, all those glory that are eating, all those spirits that are eating my glory little by little, conquer for me, O Lord. Conquer for me, O Lord. Deliver me from all these problems. I pray, O Lord, all these problems that are eating my glory little by little. Everlasting Father, conquer for me. Conquer for me. Conquer for me. Deliver me from them. Deliver me from them. Deliver me from them. I pray, O Lord, all those spirits that are eating my glory little by little, I pray against them. Because when they are start on you, little by little, you that are very, very active, you now become slow. You now become slow. Those are the spirits that are eating you little by little, but you are not being conscious and you don't realize. People will now be saying to you, oh, she's becoming old, she's getting old. You are forgetting that your neighbors, they are spending 120 years and they are still very, very active. They are still very, very active. Now, call upon Jesus Christ 3 times. Holy Spirit one time. Those spirits that wants to be robbing me of my glory little by little, that want to be eating my glory little by little, so that I can go back to square one, so that I can go back to square one. King of glory, stop working on me. Stop working on me. The Lord has already revealed your secret. Today, the Lord is upon you. The Lord come upon you. The Lord come upon you. Today, flee from me. Flee from me. Free from me. Depart from me, all ye these evil spirits. Depart from me. Depart from me. Because little by little, you are coming to eat my glory. I used to get paid about 1,000. But the following month is 900. Following month is 800. Following month is going to 750. It's going little by little and keep dropping. It keeps dropping and it keeps dropping. It keeps dropping and it keeps dropping. Oh, by the time it's May, maybe it'll be around 600. Ah, that's problem. That's problem. You better be cautious. Be careful and be conscious. Call upon Jesus Christ. Spirit of me to be conscious. Spirit of me to be conscious. Already descended upon me today. All ye spirits that are eating my glory, little by little. I call upon you for the Lord Jesus Christ 3 times. Holy Spirit one time. All those spirits that are eating little by little, go into the sea. Continue to pray in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Everlasting Father. King of kings, Lord of lords, all those spirits that are eating me little by little, I pray all those spirits go into the sea, go into the sea, go into the sea, so that I can have peace, so that I can have peace. Help me, O Lord. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. This is time, pray. Eli children cause problem into their life, into his lives. Call upon Jesus' name. Call upon his name right now, that person that will deceive me to lose my glory. King of glory, deliver me, deliver me, deliver me. That person that will take you to that place that you go and lose your glory. Some people, they will take you to that business, but that business will cause problems in your life. Call upon Jesus Christ. Eli, Ophanes, Ophanes and his brother caused problem in the life of Israelites. Call upon the name of the Lord Jesus Christ 3 times. Holy Spirit one time. Those people that will come next to me and bring me problems. Everlasting Father, conquer for me. Conquer for me. Call upon Jesus Christ 3 times. Holy Spirit one time. King of glory. Those people that they will be their friends and they will cause problems into my life. Separate us, O Lord. Continue to pray. In the name of Jesus Christ, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, Holy Spirit, all those people that I work with, that I become my friends, and will cause problems in my life, separate us, O Lord. Separate us, O Lord. Separate us, O Lord. Do not allow anybody to spoil my glory. Do not allow any man to stop my glory. Do not allow any woman to spoil my glory. Don't let me go back to square one. Call me by a new name. In Jesus' name I pray, amen. Shout and call upon the name of the Lord Jesus Christ and say that name, that name, that name that I've been called in spirit. The name that they are calling me in spirit and I'm bearing it physically. Some people have been called very stupid names. The name that comes with curses. Oh, I pray, all those names that you've been named in spirit. Call upon Jesus Christ and say, every soul that are calling me the names that have not been named from my parents, oh Lord, deliver me from those names. Deliver me from those unclean names. King of glory, every name that they are calling me in spirit, everlasting Father, erase them. Erase them. Erase those names. All those names that I have been called, that is not my real name, that is not the name of my glory. Turn it to good. Turn it to good. Turn it to good. Change those names, O Lord. Continue to pray in Jesus' name, in Jesus' name, in Jesus' name. Holy Spirit, every name that they are calling me in spirit and it's reflecting physically, King of glory, all those mouths that are calling me those names, begin to tear them down. Begin to tear them down. Begin to tear them down. In Jesus' name I pray. The final prayer point. They said, glory has departed from Israel because the Ark of Covenant is gone. Now call upon Jesus. Call upon Jesus Christ, the Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit, anything that I've done to cause my glory to be departed from me, everlasting Father, call back my glory. Call back my glory. Bring my glory back unto me. Bring back my glory to me. All my glory that has been lost, come back to my life. Come back to my life. Make a new covenant with me. Continue to pray in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Everlasting Father. Everlasting Father, anything that I've eaten that has made me to lose my glory, King of glory, cover me with the garments of glory. Cover me with the garments of glory. Bring glory back into my life. Let my glory come back unto me. Let my glory come back unto me. Let my glory come back to me. Empower me, O Lord. Guard me, O Lord. Guard me, O Lord. I'll be able to worship you. I'll be able to continue to worship you. In Jesus' name I pray, amen. The Lord said, come, let us make man in our own image. He said, let there be light, and there was light. I pray for you today. That problem that will make you to go back to square one. Maybe it's only 5 years for you to be in glory. Maybe after that 5 years, you want to go back to poverty. I pray for you that all those spirits that say that you have to go back to square one, I pray for you today. I pray for you today. I pray for you today. May those spirits free from you. May the Lord give you victory. May the Lord give you victory. May the Lord give you life. May the Lord give you life. All those power that wants you to lose your glory, all those hands that wants to fast with your glory, may those hands be weary. May those hands be weary. May those hands be weary. Every voice that is speaking unto you that wants you to lose your glory, I pray for you today. All those spirits that are tormenting you, they have been nailed to the cross. They have been nailed to the cross. They have been nailed to the cross. Every spirit of Ichabod in your life, you have been called Ichabod. Today, your names are changed. You have been called Beulah because your land will heal people. You've been called Hephzibah because the Lord is happy with you. You no more be forsaken. You no more be forsaken. You no more be called desolate. You no more be forsaken. You no more be desolate. Anybody calling you Ichabod, they shall be Ichabod themselves. They shall be Ichabod by themselves. Today, the goodness of the Lord is upon you. You are delivered from poverty. You are delivered from sorrow. It is so. It's never be reversed. In Jesus' name, I pray for you. Amen. 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 That I see this morning. That is it this morning. Anybody that wants going to depart from you, glory shall depart from them. You continue to be in joy. You continue to be in joy. Go on YouTube and search for Open TV. Open TV. Go there and listen. There are lots of it on YouTube already. So it's now up to you to go there and listen and make use of them. Yes, as the Lord liveth, you continue to remain in glory. You will not be departed from glory. The Lord will be with you. It is so. It will never be reversed. In Jesus' name I prayed. Amen. 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 I'm the one in next for testimony.